Want to know how to get actual maps into your ArcGIS Collector app? Well, stay tuned to find out. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another exciting tutorial. So, what are we going to talk about today? You guessed it, preparing your web maps for use in the Collector for ArcGIS app. Some of you may have asked, how do I actually use the Collector app to collect data? Well, you have to create your web maps in ArcGIS Online and share these web maps. And this is what I'm about to show you now. First, you will sign into your ArcGIS Online account by going to ArcGIS.com. I like to use Google Chrome when I visit the site. I kind of find that it acts and responds a little bit better, if you understand what I mean. Once signed in, you can go to the content tab. You could find your service that you published and add it to a new map with full editing control. So in a way, when you do that, it's like you're telling ArcGIS Online that this map will be used in Collector. So once it is open, you can adjust your symbology if you want to right then and there. And then you can zoom into your country or your area where you'll be collecting data. Usually, when you publish your service, each feature is automatically renamed with the service name first, followed by the feature. So now I'm actually changing it back to just the feature name, as you can see here. Now that you've renamed your features, you can play around with your map some more by moving your layers up or down in order of significance. You can again change your symbology or configure your pop-ups. So I've changed my mind and now I want to make some changes to my symbols. So if I go to the legend, these are what my symbols look like now. If I go back to the content section and click on change style, I can change it right here. Setting up your web map, you need to save it. So you need to add your title, your tags, and your description. At this point, you could share it with your group, and this is how only specific individuals will have access to your web map. This is when you share it with a group that only those individuals are a part of. If you have not created a group, I will show you how to do that in just a moment. Saving and sharing your web map with your group, you can enable other settings like enabling attachments. If you go to the settings section, you will see that the enable editing and the enable sync, they are automatically checked. This is because we did this from the publishing stage. You can always check them here if you didn't at the publishing stage. So, if you need to create a group, you will have to go to the Groups tab in your ArtJS online login, then select Create New Group and enter your details. After creating the group, you can update the sharing for your web map to be used in Collector. Now that you've completed your web map, you are ready to collect data. By now, you must be wondering, how do I collect data in the Collector app without using Wi-Fi or cellular data? In other words, how do I collect data offline? Or, now that I've collected my data, how do I get it off ArcGIS Online and into my geodatabase? Well, stay tuned to my next tutorial to find out just how to accomplish this. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.